Live to our team of reporters now, and Fiona Willen begins our coverage in Canberra. Fee, the PM has started the countdown to reopen Australia.
Carl, so this is the plan. So the National Cabinet will use the next 4 weeks to try and meet a set of three goals. So these are the conditions that have to be met before it's safe to start easing restrictions. So number one, we need a broader testing regime. So if we do ease social distancing, health authorities will be able to identify outbreaks very quickly and respond to them. Number two is better contact tracing. So at the moment, tracing's done by a team of public health workers. In a couple of weeks, there should be a phone app available that will help with tracing. And number three, we need to be able to respond more quickly to local outbreaks and increase our ability to lock them down. But Scott Morrison has warned that things won't suddenly go back to the way they were.
Social distancing, the washing of the hands, the doing all of those things, that is something we should do until we find a vaccine.
Now, the economic support measures that go hand in hand with the restrictions will end on September 30. The Prime Minister says that six-month timeframe gives us a ticking clock, and what happens in the next month will really be key, Carl.
Sure will, Fee. Thank you.
They were made to ground hundreds of flights, but today Australian Airlines are putting planes back in the sky thanks to some help from the federal government. Today, Queensland reporter Jessica Millwood is at Brisbane Airport. And Jess, can you explain how this is going to work?
Well, Ali, from today, 59 extra Qantas and Jetstar services, 64 for Virgin, will begin operating return services to our capitals and major regional centres. This will be to get essential workers where they need to go, to get those people who have been serving time in quarantine home, and importantly, to keep freight moving across the country. This will be paid for by the federal government at a cost of $165 million, and it will mean some airline staff can go back to work. That is the good news, but this assistance will far from help Virgin with all of their problems. Crisis talks will take place today, and voluntary administration for them remains a very real prospect. Ali?
Okay, thanks, Jess.
Crown has stood down almost its entire workforce. 11,500 employees will lose their jobs, around 95% of employees in Melbourne and Perth. Casuals will be compensated with $1,000. Part-time and full-time workers receiving 2 weeks' pay. Meanwhile, the gambling giant has secured $1 billion in funding from banks to survive the pandemic. To breaking news now on a coronavirus outbreak in Western Sydney, Nine News can exclusively reveal there's been a spike in the number of cases at the Newmarch House aged care home near Penrith. A total of 20 residents and 10 staff have now tested positive at the Cadence facility. We'll bring you more details as they come to us here in the newsroom. The first overseas death linked to the Ruby Princess has been recorded as a deadline looms for authorities to test every single crew member still on board. Today, reporter Sarah Stewart is at Port Kembla, south of Sydney, where the ship is docked. Sarah, what do we know about this passenger?
Well, good morning to you, Alex. This story just gets sadder by the day. We know the latest passenger to die is a 76-year-old grandfather from America. He was a passenger on the ship. He returned home to America where he started showing some symptoms. He was taken to hospital, was placed on a ventilator for 2 weeks, but sadly passed away on April 9. We know he was on the ship with his wife, who was also tested positive, but she is not showing any symptoms at the moment. That takes the death toll to 2019 from here, and now one from America, as well as hundreds of other people who have now been infected with COVID-19. The race is now on to test all the crew members on the ship, as we've been told. The ship is set to leave Australian waters on Sunday, so that means there is now 48 hours to test all of the crew on board. If that does happen, it is believed that the ship will go on to Manila, where 500 Filipino crew workers will leave the ship, but it all depends if we can test all of those crew members before Sunday. Alex?
Sarah Stewart, thank you.
The National Cabinet has agreed to seven principles guiding the way forward for schools, but decisions on when students will be back in classrooms rests with the states. In New South Wales, there will be more in-classroom lessons from week three of term two. Premier Gladys Berejiklian spoke with Nine News last night.
New South Wales is considering a number of options, including, you know, a staggered process whereby students might have a day or two a week over a certain period of time face-to-face. But we're looking at all those options now.
The PM acknowledged there would be differences among the states and territories on a timeframe for face-to-face learning. AFL could be back as soon as July. A league boss saying he's confident a date will be set in stone by the end of the month. Christina Hearn is in Melbourne. Chris, does this mean footy fans will be back in the stadiums anytime soon?
Well, Carl, while footy might be coming back, unfortunately, footy fans won't be. Most likely for the rest of the season, they'll be watching these matches at home on TV. But there's a growing sense of optimism here at league headquarters that by April 27, they are going to have a firm date for footy fans on when training is going to resume, but more importantly, when matches are going to resume, most likely in July. It is looking like these matches will be played in various quarantined hubs around the country. That means players will be spending an extended period of time away from home. So the league is working towards making sure family can travel with them.
Now, we're aware of the broader piece around players, broadly their mental health. And part of that is access to families and others and connection with the community.
Interestingly, the league says no longer will there be an automatic 30-day shutdown if a player tests positive for coronavirus. Carl.
Interesting. Christina Hearn, thank you.
Drivers across the country can now fill up the tank for as little as $1 a litre, prices we haven't seen in almost 20 years. Let's go to Today reporter Gabrielle Boyle, who is at West Ryde in Sydney's northwest. And Gabby, where can drivers find the cheapest fuel?
Yeah, good morning, Ali. Well, they can find cheap fuel right around Australia, and that's great news given that so many people have found themselves unemployed or in financial difficulty given coronavirus right across Australia. We're seeing an almost 20-year low, averages of less than a dollar in many places. In Sydney, I'll run you through those prices. In Sydney, we're seeing 99 cents a litre, Brisbane 97 cents a litre, Melbourne $1.04 a litre, Adelaide $1.06 a litre, and Perth $1.08 a litre. These are extraordinarily low prices, and they are expected to last, Ali, for at least the next few weeks.
If only we could go somewhere. Thanks, Gabby.
We watched her grow up, and now we can watch her walk down the aisle. Bindi Irwin's big day is being screened on TV. The one-hour special filmed at Australia Zoo will air on Animal Planet tomorrow. Here's a quick look.
You'll be holding a wormer python, Mum will be holding
my favorite koala.
Yep. It'll be really special. Chandler's parents will walk down the aisle next. And then finally, we'll have some gorgeous macaws fly through the space.
Oh.
So it'll be beautiful.
Who needs doves?
Oh, doves. Bindi and her new husband Chandler managed to tie the knot before social distancing guidelines came in place. With 200 people and plenty of animals there to bear witness. Honeymoon's off for the moment.
That's my weekend sorted.
Watching the wedding. Yeah, it'll be beautiful.
Oh, lovely.
I mean, calls flying down the aisle.
The family's been through a lot.
Yeah.
I'm going to be sitting there. Obviously, I wasn't invited. Mm. But I'll be watching with my popcorn.
You'll be weeping.
I will.
Yeah.
I weep.